Hi everyone, Rach here from Book Piles. Welcome to a video, surprisingly. I'm having some technical difficulties, which is why I haven't had a lot of videos in the last couple of weeks. I'm still trying to figure it out, and hopefully this will work. This is going to be a one-take wonder, potentially unedited, which means that I may not be able to put any book covers in the video like I normally do, but I'll write all the books down and their authors in the description below. We'll see how we go. I've got 19 minutes before this shuts off, so I've got to get this video filmed in less than that time. Otherwise, then if the problem is my editing software, I'm stuffed. So let's get cracking. So this video is for my TBR for September, and I'm going to do Series September, which is hosted by Krista at Books and Jam and Sarah at Sarah's Nightstand. I'll link hopefully both their intro videos in the description as well. I made a page for my book section of my planner. There are 9 prompts on the bingo board. It's both the girls that I watched said it's a very loose, casual readathon. Well, in fact, even readathon isn't a term they're using. They basically said if you read a book in a series, you have participated in Series September. But I'm going all out. I'm going for a historical romance Series September, because that's what I want to read at the moment. So I have worked out everything. There are 9 prompts and I've got 10 books. And I'm only doubling up on 2 prompts for the one book for 2 prompts, I think. Otherwise, I mean, I could do more, I could double it up, but we've got the whole month, there's no need to. I can read a historical romance in 24 hours if I put my mind to it, and I've got nothing else to do. So anyway, I try not to waffle, let's crack on. So I'll tell you the prompt, and I'll tell you, I've got my TBR on the back, I will tell you what I'm reading for it. I can show you 2 books, the rest are all ebooks on my Kindle. So as I say, if I can get this through the editing program and it works, I'll show you the covers. If not, I'm sorry. anyway, so prompt number 1 is to start a series. And for that, I'm starting The Duke Goes Down by Sophie Jordan. And that came out this month, end of July or beginning of August this month, something like that. It's new. So that's going to be my starter series. Prompt 2 is read 2 books in the same series. And for that, it's also going to be Sophie Jordan's. And I didn't actually write this. Oh, yes, I did. So this is the Rogue Files series I'm going to use for this. And I'm going to read books 3 and 4. So book 1, I think, was While the Duke Was Sleeping. Book 2 was The Scandal of It All, something like that. And I've read both of those previously. So book 3 is The Duke Buys a Bride. And this is, I won't waste time trying to tell you what the books are about, because some of them I know and some I don't actually. So we want to keep the time short. So yeah, book 3 is The Duke Buys a Bride, and book 4 is The Scot of Mine. So that's for read 2 books in the same series. Prompt 3, read your newest series purchase. For that, I'm stretching a little. When I wrote this up and worked it out, I went on the newest series purchase at that moment. It is now not the newest series purchase, but we're neither here nor there. And that is The Casanova by T.L. Swan. So this is actually a contemporary romance. It's the only one that's a contemporary. And I have held off. I've been dying to read this, but I have held off for Series September, and it'll be the first one I read. So that's a contemporary rather than a historical romance. And that's book 3 in the Miles High Club by T.L. Swan. Prompt 4 is read a book from a series longer than 5 books. Now this one, I could have tripled for a book. Does that make sense? 1 book, 3 prompts. And gone for a Bridgerton book. But I decided, because it's the whole month, that I would look for another series. And I looked for a series that I had some of already and therefore didn't have to buy the whole series. And I have it, the series is called A Sinful Seasons by Lorraine Heath. And for prompt four, I'm reading Beyond Scandal and Desire, which I think is book one. So again, and that could have been doubled up with starter series, but as I said, I've got a whole month. So that is, yeah, four. Read a book from a series longer than five books, and that's a seven book series as far as I'm aware. Prompt five is to finish a series, and for that I am reading book eight in the Bridgertons On the Way to the Wedding, which is Gregory's story. And I'm taking that as finishing a series, even though I've got the second epilogue book, I'm not including that as part of the series. That, again, I might be taking a liberty, but that's what I'm doing. Prompt six is read the second book in a series. So for that, again, this is the Lorraine Heath series, A Sin for All Seasons. Is that what it's called? A Sins for All Seasons novel, yep. And book two is called When a Duke Loves a Woman. Prompt seven is read a duology. So I went looking on Amazon, and I came up with a Maya Rodale duology. There are only two books. Don't remember what the series is called, and I don't think I can find that off the top of my head. If I can, I'll put it in the description beside the titles of the books. So book one is called The Heir and the Spear, and it's what tickled my fancy with this was it's twins, or twin males. So I thought there might be some hijinks and some fun and games with that. So book one in the pair is The Heir and the Spear, and book two is called The Rogue and the Rival. So that is for reading a duology. Prompt eight, read a book from your most recently started series. Yeah, I'm stretching this a little bit. Recently started series, I realise. So that is The Scoundrel in Her Bed by Lorraine Heath, and that is book three in the Sins for All Seasons series. And that's why I ended up going for this series, because I already owned this book. I still have to buy the other six in the series, but you know. And book nine, again, I stretched this a little bit to make it work for me, is read a book from a series started more than a year ago. And that is actually going to be the Bridgerton series book, because technically I started it 2 years ago when I read An Offer from a Gentleman. Oh, I should show you that one, shouldn't I, up here? I actually read An Offer from a Gentleman 2 years ago before I understood that it was a series and it was part three of the series, and then I brought the books that year as well, but I didn't actually then continue on with the series until this year. So that started more than a year ago. So that is my all the books for the prompts. I would hope that I will get this done halfway through September. It won't take the whole month to read these books. I think I worked out that there are 10 altogether. And then what I'll do for the rest of the month is either carry on with some series, so the Sophie Jordan series or the Lorraine Heath series. I think those are the only two. I can't carry on with the Sophie Jordan Duke Goes Down series because that's new and the second book doesn't come out till next year. And the same with T.L. Swan. There must be a fourth book coming because there are four brothers and this is the third brother's story. So I will either carry on with the Rogue Files series, Sophie Jordan, or the Sin for All Seasons series, Lorraine Heath. I've also got the second epilogue book, which I think I'll probably read too, and then just whatever takes my fancy. So that is my plan for September. If all goes well, you should see this complete with book covers. If you don't, The problem is the editing software, and we will be doing some one take wonders for a little while we try and figure out how we're going to get around this problem. I will be back with what I've read in August, and some of my August book haul subject to editing, because I've actually brought quite a bit on the Kindle, and unless I you know, I can't show you those, but I have got some physical books as well. Alright, so this is short and sweet. It needs to be to see how this is all going to work. I will catch you again soon. Happy reading, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye for now.